And it's a song about a man called Lord Courtown, who was one of the more generous lords. Usually the lords don't get a good rap in the Irish songs. They're fairly nefarious characters. But this guy did a lot of famine relief work, and I was delighted to hear that there was a song written about him. I don't know any more about the song. How happy our countrymen when seasons do come on, to hear the lark and linnet melodiously sing songs. Likewise the thrush on every bush are melting notes to ring, to welcome home Lord Courtown in the day's approaching spring. The trees grow tall and handsome, the leaves with honey drew, and underneath the swan he swims with his long neck and stoops. Likewise the common angler with his long line and hook to convey the trout and salmon out of the charming brook. This lord he built a castle at the rising of yon hill. The works of it were marveled on for its artifice and skill. There's a sort of stroke work with it that could ne'er be equalized. It's embellished with green ivy that never fades nor dies. This lord he sank a river more plainly to be seen. He dug it to a certain depth, full 15 feet, full clean. The Straits of Gibraltar could ne'er more rapid roar than the Straits of Unavara flowing to the Courtown shore. One day I was amusing down by the Courtown bank. The sun shone bright and clearly while kind Neptune played a prank. It was there I spied a charming maid, most charming to be seen. In her figure she came bidding down, her measure maids wore green. There was Flora at the helm, Aurora to the stern, and all our gallant fine seamen their course for to steer on. I being so much delighted at her fine sails all o'er, I thought myself in paradise down by the Courtown shore. I have been in New Zealand and and likewise in Peru. And many ancient places my eyes have took a view, but as fine a place as Courtown my eyes did not yet behold. It far outshines proud Mexico, though its banks are lined with gold. That's it.